Hello friends, welcome back to my channel and thank you for all your comments on my previous videos. I am very happy to read those and let us go into this new topic what I brought for you today. Today's topic is about colors. We are going to learn some basics and some fun facts about colors. Okay, it is time to go into the details of our topic. There are three basic colors. They are red, yellow and blue. In addition to this, there are three secondary colors which are orange, green and violet. In addition to this, there are six tertiary colors which are red, orange, yellow green, blue green, blue violet and red violet. So we just saw that there are only few colors. So how do we make other colors? So if we combine two primary colors with each other, you get a so-called secondary color. If you mix red and blue, you get violet. Yellow and red becomes orange. Blue and yellow become green. If you mix all the primary colors together, you get black. One can mix two or more of these new colors to create another color. Even though colors are almost endless, a healthy human sight or a human eye has three types of cone cells, each of which can register about 100 different colors and shades. Therefore, most researchers ballpark the number of colors we can distinguish is at around a million of colors. Okay, it's time to understand more about the colors. Color temperature affects us both psychologically and perpetually by helping us determine how objects appear positioned. Based on the temperature of the color, they can be classified into three ways: warm, cool, and neutrals. Warm colors are red, orange, and yellow. They attract our eyes quickly. Warm color appear closer to the observer. Cool colors are green, purple and blue. Blue is the only primary color within the cool color spectrum. They are often subdued with warm colors. Cool colors appear farther from the observers. Neutral colors are black, white, gray, tans and browns. The meanings and impressions of neutral colors depend on the colors in and around them. There are also other ways of classifying colors, like positive and negative, receding and advancing, subtractive and additive. What is achromatic color? Any color that lacks chromatic content is said to be unsaturated, achromatic, near neutral or neutral. Near neutrals include browns, tans, pastels and other darker colors. Near neutrals can be of any hue or lightness. Pure achromatic or neutral colors include black, white and all grays. What are the commonly known colors? They are red, yellow, blue, brown, orange, green, violet, black, pink, indigo, white and gray. Most of us will know what are the rainbow colors. There are seven colors. Let us go through them. They are violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow and red, and shortly called as Vibhyard. When the sun makes rainbows, the sunlight passes through raindrops. The raindrops act like tiny prisms. They bend on different colors in white light, so the light spreads out into a band of colors that can be reflected back to as a rainbow. And do you know the most favorite color of the world's current population is? That is just blue. Color is spelled in British English as COLOUR and COLOR in American English. You will see similar change in spellings like flavor, humor, labor between British and American English, where U will be missing in American English. Now let us understand whether white and black are really colors. Black is the absence of light. Unlike white and other hues, pure black can exist in nature without any light at all. Some consider white to be a color because of its white light comprises all hues on the visible light spectrum. But in a technical sense, black and white are not colors, they are shades. Now one can ask, what is shade? So what is the difference between colors and shade is, colors, technically known as hue, describes an element found in the color spectrum. Whereas shades, also known as tints, are of a particular hue ranging darker to black and lighter to white. Example, the flames used in yellow, orange and red colors can differ the way they appear to our eyes. So you can see in this example, there are red with different shades, but they are called differently because of the darkness or the lightness of the shades. What is color blindness? Color blindness occurs when you are unable to see colors in a normal way. It is also known as color deficiency. Color blindness often occurs when someone cannot distinguish between certain colors. This usually happens between green and red, and occasionally blues as well. Deuter anomaly is the most common type of red-green color blindness. It makes green looks more red. Whereas proto anomaly makes red looks more like green and less bright than they actually appear. Protonopia and deuteranopia both makes you unable to tell the difference between red and green at all. Let us see some quick facts. Some of them could be even fun too. The human eye can see approximately 1 million colors. Red is the first color a baby sees. This is due to wavelengths of the red being the longest. Pink suppresses anger. Many prisons and mental health institutes often paint their walls pink to calm the inmates and patients. Red and yellow are the most appetizing colors. You can see this in many fast food chain logos like McDonald's, Pizza Hut, Wimpy, etc. Mosquitoes are drawn to the darker colors. That is why you see mosquitoes in a darker area. Colors stimulates memory. If you are having a hard time remembering notes you have written down, it may be worth writing in a colored paper or using a pen with colored ink. So each one again have a different color preference, so you can choose your colors. Men and women see the world differently as women's brains has 2X chromosomes when compared to men who has only one. Do you know that the safest car color in the world, as per the latest statistics, is white, as it is visible in all conditions except snow? Colors impact the taste too. For instance, an orange or creamy colored cup makes chocolate taste better than if it is consumed in any other colored cup. Do you want to know how the colored word is spelled or pronounced in other languages? This is how it is. I am not going to read this. For sure, I am going to make a mistake. So I will leave it to you for your reading. So this is how a color thesaurus will look like, and you can see all kind of colors and shades with the names here. You can spend some time on it to identify which colors you don't know or which you want to learn, which you already know, etc. And have fun. Finally, some fun questions for your thoughts. When orange is a word which is used to refer to a color as well as a fruit, do you know which one was discovered first? Think about it. And please comment if you know the answer. If The second one is, if you can see all objects in the world only by their colors, how can you see water but not air, when both are said to have no colors? Again, please comment if you know the answer. Thank you, friends, for watching this video. Please comment, subscribe, share, and click the bell icon for more updates from our channel. Thank you very much, and have a good day.